drinking actually about since 6 a.m. so we're good. Right now we are going straight to the flea market and the Brojo, which is the same area. Flea market is one street and at the end that's where the Brojo is. So we're gonna stay there for about an hour and a half so you can do your shopping, eat, and then we're gonna get back in the same bus. You're always going to be in the same bus, number 44, okay? So when we get there, I'm going to set up a time to come back to the bus. So you need to be in time so you don't actually get left over there and you have to swim 21 miles, right? Just be sure to make it back on time. When we get to the flea market, I'm going to let you know where the good places to eat are, all the stuff is, where the a very famous place called Habana Banana, where there's animals, there's actually tigers, lions, and all that stuff. And there's also a tequila tasting there, a free tequila tasting, which is really, really good tequila. So it's really, really good. So I'll show you all that stuff up there. I'm gonna actually, once I walk you through, I'm gonna be walking around all the time. I'm going to be actually taking care of you, making sure you're okay. Until it's time to go back, then I'll come back to the bus and I'll wait for you here. But in the time, I'm gonna be around there, so I'll make sure that you're actually doing all right, you're bargaining all right and all that, right? You're using your bargaining skills, because you need them up there. Everybody's gonna actually bargain with you a lot. So always, the only thing that is not negotiable up there is actually food. Other than that, everything else, even medicine is actually negotiable up there, okay? So that's why we offer this tour, not only because of the Brojo, because the shopping is better up there. So the city of Ensenada right now has 140 years of existence. Population in Ensenada, it's a little over 700,000 people. 5 years ago, believe it or not, we only had about 500,000 people, and that's up to 700,000 people. In 5 years. The reason of that is very simple. We're Catholic and we're Mexicans. So yeah, no birth control. A lot of small people. Also, we have a lot of migration. Migration from Mexico, from central, southern Mexico, and also migration from the north. We have right now in Ensenada the largest population of retired Americans in all Mexico. Here, Ensenada right now, over 200,000 retired Americans, wow, full time. The reason of that is very simple. It's close to the border. We're only an hour away from the border, north. It actually takes you 1 hour to get to the border. And then it's the closest town to the border that is really safe. I mean, we're the safest port in Mexico. Mainly the cost of living. Cost of living here comparable to the United States, especially California, our neighbors, it's nothing. So that's why they come here, they retire, and they live very, very happy. Because it's really affordable to live here. Gasoline, just gasoline. We use the metric system, so those prices you see up there, they're actually pesos and they're liters. The conversion to gallons, it'll be about $3.10 for a gallon. That's what we're paying right now here. And the same with the all the other utilities, the houses, everything. It's actually, even the rents are actually really affordable. So it is all very affordable. That's why they retire here. So you'll see a lot of California license plates in the streets. See, right there. And you'll see everywhere you actually turn, you're gonna see at least one or two cars with California license plates. That means they're leaving here because it's a weekday. Right now we're going south. You take this road now south and it takes you all the way to Cabo San Lucas. It actually ends in Cabo. Cabo from here is 950 miles away. It's actually about 20 hours to get there. That's a far drive from me to Cabo. Far, far drive. It's a beautiful drive, but it's a far drive. So there's three main industries here in Ensenada. Agriculture is the number one. We actually do a lot of farming. So agriculture is the number one. Tourism is the second one, and manufacturing is the third one. We do a lot of manufacturing here. Most of the manufacturing we do is textile factories. There's a lot of clothing factories. But agriculture is the number one industry. We happen to be sending right now to the United States about 75% of our fields. It's a big production going across the border. And we also are the wine country of Mexico. We produce here in Ensenada 95% of the Mexican wine. We have over 100 wineries here in town. That's a big business here in town too. So our vegetables, our our fruits. They're always really, really affordable, really actually good. Unscheduled stop, guys, don't worry. We'll go in a moment, right? This bus has a very particular system. When we go through that, actually that highway, right, this block only, if actually we don't go out fast enough with it, it has a sensor that actually turns off the bus right there. So if we go fast, that doesn't matter. And it's the only bus from the whole company, it's the only bus that has it. And they have looked for that sensor and they haven't found it. So I don't know what's, there's something in that strip or something right there that actually triggers that sensor and turns off the bus, just in that area. And as soon as we get there, no more problem. When we get back on the other side of the street, there's no sensor, so there's no actually, only on the way over here. And this bus only, 44, only. That is the only sensor, and I don't know why. There's nothing there that it's probably under the or on top. I don't know what, but it triggers that sensor. So I was saying, we actually export a lot of vegetables from here. We don't actually export a lot of wine. The wine is mostly consumed here in Mexico because we don't have a big production of it. But it is really, really good wine. We actually enter wine festivals and contests all over the world, and we actually bring a lot of gold and silver medals, mostly. So our wine is really, really good. The reason we are the safest port in Mexico, one of the reasons is this place. This place is the naval base. This is the second largest naval base in Mexico. We have the second largest naval base and the third largest army base of all Mexico here in Ensenada. We also are going to go through the army base, but this is the naval base. A lot of military families in town, that's why it's safe. A lot of military families here. We have here in Ensenada, we actually don't have a problem, and you won't see any, and actually you won't see any. Homeless people. There's actually not a problem with homeless people here, like they have in a lot of cities in the United States. We don't have it here. In Mexico, you probably know that Mexicans are really hard workers, right? We start really young. In Mexico also, the other reason is we don't have any welfare unemployment. So here, if you don't work, you don't get nothing. You cannot live for free. So if you're actually in the streets and you wanna actually live for free, and the government actually giving you money, that's not gonna happen. If you actually go to the government and ask for money, if you're not working, they'll kick you in the ass. Go to work. But if you work, you get free medical, you get benefits, you get credit to buy a house, you get a lot of stuff. So that's why everybody's working. Everybody wants to work. You see this area right there? That is retired Americans. So you see that house right there, the brown and green house right there? That house was selling a year and a half ago. That is 4 bedrooms, 3 complete bathrooms across the street from the beach. That house was selling for $110,000 a year and a half ago. It's still the same price, but it's already sold, but it'll be the same price. Property taxes on a house that big right now in Ensenada, it'll be $60 a year. So that's the cost of living here, man, in Ensenada. That's why we have so many American people moving down here. Because they know that, and they love living here and actually enjoying our beautiful beach. This is actually called Playa Hermosa, which means beautiful beach. Playa Hermosa. That island in front of us over there, kind of barely see it right now with the fog, but it's actually, there's an island right in front. It is called Todos Santos, all the Saints Island. That island is the one that breaks up big swells, tsunamis. We don't get nothing like that here. Because this water is cold, and our climate is not tropical. We don't get tropical storms, no hurricanes, nothing like that either. So we're safe from all that. We don't have to worry about that. Remodeling the beach right here, the beach area, they're doing more better bathrooms and all that stuff, so they're doing a lot of stuff right here. It's gonna turn into a very nice area for next summer. So that is one of the reasons you don't see any homeless people here in Mexico, because of that. But you need to be a Mexican citizen to be able to work. If you're a foreigner, you cannot work in Mexico. It's only Mexican citizens, so they can get the.
But you can retire and live.
Oh yeah, you can actually apply for dual citizenship too. So you can have that. You can have dual citizenship. But unless you turn Mexican or you actually get the citizenship for Mexican, you cannot work.
Then you have to do that to own property?
No, not anymore. To own property, you just be a resident. You get a, you buy property, you actually go to the immigration office and you get a permanent resident visa. It's called FM1. And you get it in 2 weeks and it's free. But you have to prove that you bought, or you're renting, or you bought a permanent resident here.
What if you want to work, but don't want the benefits? Does it allow you to still work? No?
As a business owner, yeah. As a business owner, you can work. But not as an employee. As an employee, no. But as a business owner, yeah, definitely. They encourage that, actually. So a lot of most of the factories here are American or Korean because of that. They encourage people. The taxes are really low and all that stuff. Yeah, exactly. So they can come and invest over here.
Is it cash only at all the shops?
No. You can use cards anyway. Yeah. The shops up there in the flea market, they won't take any like Apple Pay, nothing like that. But yeah, they'll take cards. Okay. But in some of the businesses in town, you can actually pay with Apple Pay and all that stuff too. Some of those applications. But in the up there, it's just a regular card. So this is Highway 1 right now. We're gonna enter to Highway 1 and we're gonna start going south. This is the main highway. Once we get to this highway, you're going to see a lot of commercial trucks going back and forth. That is the export that we do. Like I said, we export every single day, vegetables and everything that is manufactured in the factories. So these trucks are going back and forth here in the border, and this road, you'll see them. This is the commercial road, you can say. So you'll see a lot of night and day.
How long have you been doing this?
Me? 25 years, man.
Wow.
Yes.
Awesome. Thank you. Very knowledgeable.
Thank you.
You were a kid.
I tried.
You were a kid when you started.
I was a kid. Yes. I'm not that young, but yeah, I was young. Yeah. Yeah. I love it. See, California lets me live there more. So, Kia is manufactured here in Mexico. We're one of the biggest manufacturers of cars in the world right now. We're the number four manufacturer of cars in the world. So Kia has a factory in Tijuana, same as Toyota. We don't manufacture any here in Ensenada, but the closest ones are Tijuana. And that's a Nissan. Nissan is also manufactured here in Mexico, but it's in another state. And some of the big warehouses you're going to see around here, that is the factory. So they all have names like Ensenada Textile, Elegant Fashion. They all have names like that because, like I said, most of them are textile factories. But believe it or not, now that you actually come in you actually like music and all that, believe it or not, and they're probably, I don't know if the guys from the band are actually gonna do a tour there or they're gonna take him there, I don't know. But we have a Fender guitar factory here in town. One of the biggest Fender guitar factories in the world is here in Ensenada.
Vale, Fender Mexico is acá.
So yeah, that's one of the biggest factories here in town. I'll show it to you once we get through it. We also have four universities here in town. A lot of kids come to study here to Ensenada because it's very affordable. This is the State University. The State University, you have to be a resident from the state to be able to study there. That's $100 a semester, including books. Yes. The medical school that we have here in Ensenada, we have a medical school that is actually ranked in the top 20 medical schools in Mexico. We have American kids, Puerto Rican kids, and Cuban kids studying medicine there. That one is $1,000 a semester, including books. Look at this place. We call this place, started from Carl Jr. and all this area, we call this place Little America. Walmart, Home Depot, Applebee's, McDonald's, Burger King, Starbucks, so Little America. Costco on this side over here. Let's have a Costco. So same, Costco is also also they adapt to our economy, so it's cheaper. Costco here, the membership, just the membership is $25 here.
Wow.
The regular membership.
Can you go to the ones in America on that membership?
Yes, sir. Yeah. It works over there. I mean, yours works over here.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah.
Does the Fender factory down here do tours?
No, not yet. They're working on it. I'm pretty sure. Actually, they were working on it before the pandemic and then stopped. But now they're actually going again. They're doing. They're actually working on it. That blue building back there.
Yeah.
Barely see it, but that blue building back there, that's a desalination plant. We actually built a desalination plant about 6 years ago. So in case we get to a drought, we don't have to worry anymore because we have that plant. So it's gonna be providing water
for
pretty much ever. That's Fender back there. You'll see the sign right now. As soon as we clear this building, you'll see us. All back there. It's actually it's the whole block, and all that behind this one is all that. It's a huge factory. Huge. They do all everything. All that back there is Fender. So that's amps, bass guitars, acoustic guitars, everything. Strings, everything. They do everything.
Fendi.
No, Fendi.
No, Fendi, no.
A ella le interesa Fendi. No, Fendi. So, in Mexico, all the gas stations, even that they're actually, if they're not the same, they have to have the same price. There's actually no competition between them. They have to be, it's a set price for all of them. This is the army base. The army base started right there in this corner. As long as you see that wall, it's gonna be army base. So it goes actually four stoplights that way. You'll see how big it is. It's huge. As long as you see that wall, it's army base. And that right there is our city hall. That is city hall right there.
Army base.
So this is the third largest in Mexico, and it's huge. The trees inside the army base, all those trees surrounding the base, those are all of them. A lot of olives, and we produce olive oil. Very good extra virgin compressed olive oil. All that is olive juice right there. So almost the whole base is full of olive trees.
Hey, question, military service mandatory?
Yes, sir. It is for men when you turn 18. But if you don't actually do it, it's mandatory because you need the paper, not because you're gonna go to jail. If you don't do it, you don't go to jail, nothing happens. You just don't get the draft card, and the draft card you practically need for everything. Marriage, passport, job, yeah. So that is mandatory.
And females also?
No
men. Female, okay.
And it's because when you're 18, you're still in school, they don't want to bother that.
Yeah.
So what the Mexican government did is actually they set up to only do it 1 year, every Saturday, from 8 a.m. to 1 p.m. That's it, for half a day. Huh. After a year, you're done, you get your draft card, and that's it. This is still a military base. This is actually the airport. There's an airport inside the army base there. We don't have a commercial airport. It is international, but it's only for small planes. We don't have a commercial airport. The closest commercial airport we have from here is Tijuana. It's 1 hour from here. But this is actually big enough for like charter planes. You can actually land here. If you charter a plane from the United States, you can land right here. Look at the stores right here. All these stores are secondhand stores. Everything that they sell right there, those guys go to yard sales in the United States. They buy that stuff, bring it away, they sell it. All that comes from yard sales in the United States. So I'm pretty sure if you walk around there, you can find your own washer and dryer, your own tools, your own mattress. Baseball is the most popular. popular sport here in town, not soccer, baseball. This is a baseball town. We have a Triple A team, actually. It's an Atlanta Mariners. So that's a dirt field, but we have a stadium in town, very nice stadium in town. Triple A stadium. And that's the trucks I was talking about. See, they're going back and forth. You'll see a lot of it. And because agriculture is so important here in town, we actually, the amount of traffic, commercial traffic, increased a lot in this highway. The highway here is actually big and it's all concrete. But down there were the agricultural fields, it wasn't. It was a very narrow road and it was pavement. So now they're doing actually a concrete highway all the way down. So they're actually, right now they're building three bridges at the same time. And they're doing, they're gonna do the concrete highway the whole way. So you'll see right now what the construction is. A big project they have down there. Solicita means they're hiring, so they're always hiring people. Seafood here is our specialty, of course. Una maquiladora que son las que pagan menos, están pagando como 1,700, 1,800 a la semana, pesos.
6,700 al menos.
Igual. Pero aquí puedes rentar una casa, por ejemplo, si esas personas no tienen una casa propia, que puedes tenerla bien fácil, pero si no la tienes, puedes rentar una casa aquí, una casa de que una dos recámaras por 2,000 pesos. Just for the food here to Ensenada, we're actually in the wine country too. It's because of that. Our food is all from here, it's all really fresh, especially the seafood. The seafood we get it from here. The Pacific is right here, and then the Sea of Cortez is 3 hours that way. So we get all the tropical fish and the shrimp from there, and all the Pacific and fish and the clams and the lobster and all that from this side. So it's all really, really close. So we get really good seafood all the time here. Even the little stands, little mini stands in the corner, they have fresh from the day. Fish, clams, oysters, everything. Up there, where we're going, in the flea market, as I walk you through the flea market, almost at the end, actually all the way at the end, before we get to the blowhole, there's a restaurant where I eat and I recommend the people there because it's so good. They have a grill on the outside. And what they do there is actually the clams. We have clams that are this big here in Ensenada. So what they do with the clam is they open the clam, they take all the meat out of the shell, they dice the meat with cilantro and tomatoes, they put butter on the shell, they throw mozzarella cheese on top, they actually put shrimp and then they put it in a grill, and it cooks in the grill right there, all of it. That thing is out of this world, you need to try one, it's so, so good. You won't find it anywhere in the world like that, it's very traditional for Ensenada, and the clams, you won't find them that big either. Those are huge, monster clams. That's really good. It's actually, they give you the plate with the two pieces and it's $8 a plate for the two pieces with the shrimp and the cheese and all that stuff in each one.
We have lobster at that restaurant?
Yes, ma'am. Yes, ma'am. Yes, ma'am. Really good lobster. Everything's really fresh from the day. Actually, the divers, because it's right next to the ocean, the divers go in the morning there and they actually take all that stuff. And
oysters. Oh, yeah.
They get it from the day.
Good for your libido. What?
It's a lot of tomatoes all from here. So those greenhouses you see right there, actually we're gonna go through them in a moment. That is all Persian cucumber. All that is Persian cucumber. They grow them inside the greenhouses actually. Oh, cheaters.
Cheaters, that's
public transportation. Sorry, our version of the taxis. taxi drivers.
Another.
Once one does it, everybody wants to do it too.
Uh-huh.
You create more chaos.
Oh, they're hot.
That's how wide the road is gonna be, see? From being a two lane, it's gonna be a six lane. All concrete.
Oh.
And then the bridges, there's three bridges being built. So this is one of them, and then two more back there. Big project, really big. Once it's finished, it's gonna be very nice. But it's been a pain in the butt. Because this is the main road, the main highway. No other. So when they close it like right now, it creates a chaos. There's a crane right there. That's the crane that we're blocking. So all that is actually Persian cucumbers right there, see? That's how they look. This one was actually, they were picked about a month ago, and look, they're already growing up again. They're actually coming up. So this area, the people who work in the fields here do the picking by hand. Everything's done by hand because it's better for the product. Because this field's a year-round production, the people who work in the fields, they don't need to migrate, so they all live here. All this stuff that you see around here, that is people who work in the fields or people that own the agriculture. Those are packaging plants. So what they do is, a lot of the companies in the United States, they already have packaging plants here, so they have deals with the owners of the field, so they actually, you will sell just to me, and they package it here, they label it, and they go straight to the border from here. And they get the exclusive, the best quality.
Asparagus.
That's how asparagus looks in the field. affordable and we produce a lot of it. So it's cheaper actually than the regular oil and it's healthier. Yeah. Some way to advertise, huh?
Yeah, I know. Wow.
Couple of trains.
It's just the outside. It doesn't have a transmission or a motor. That's why.
Oh.
So they can lift it up there. Because even with a crane, if it had a motor or a transmission, they cannot put it up there.
That's
not too heavy.
Wow.
So that doesn't have a motor or a transmission. They cannot steal it. The flowers, those are the flowers they use here in traditional Day of the Dead, which is coming up close, come by. So that's the flower they use for to take to the grave on the Day of the Dead, November 2nd. Houses right here in this area, that is all people that work in the fields, people that own agricultural fields, they all live in this area. They don't need to migrate, so they all live in this area right here. They have year-round work, they actually live well, comfortable. at those jars right there, the honey and the olives. Olive oil. So up there, you gotta get ready to put a few pounds actually, because the food up there is amazing. Even actually as I walk you through the flea market, you're gonna be eating. Because every churro stand, every piña colada stand, every candy store, they're gonna offer you samples. So all along we're gonna be snacking all along the walk. It's so, so good. The churros up there are amazing. And then I'm gonna stop in one place on the way down. The reason that I stop is because that place is the best piña colada. But they actually specialize in the strawberry colado. They are the only place that makes the strawberry colado with actual strawberries from here. And I stop on the way down because if you get it there, you get it inside the pineapple, the strawberry colado inside the pineapple, and you get a free refill on the way back. So if you buy it on the way down, you get a free refill on the way back. So definitely, once you try it, you know, it's so good. It's $10 with unlimited alcohol and a free refill, or $8 without alcohol and a free refill. See that water right there? That's a fish farm. They're actually farming tilapia there. We do a little fish farming too. Tilapia, and then we have oyster farms, and we have tuna farms in the bay. I'll show them to you right now. The oyster farms are actually right there. All the little white buoys you see up there in the water, that is actually buoys. These buoys are holding nets under the water. That's oyster farms. And the tuna farm, we'll get to them in a minute. This is where you can see what the name of the city means. Ensenada means a bay surrounded by mountains. That's what an ensenada means. That is the 21 mile swim I was talking about. It's the bus. This area, you bring $500,000 and you build a mansion. Half of the mountain that will be yours. Land is not expensive here at all. And construction materials either too. We build everything here. We manufacture everything. See that white rock right in front of us? That is our national monument to seagulls. Seagull bathroom.
Is that what that white is?
Yes, sir.
Yeah.
Wow.
At night, they're all there. They're all sleeping there, so they're also doing their necessities there. That's where we go. And see, that's the flea market. The block is just around the corner. So that's our spot down there. That's where we're gonna walk. So right now, as I walk you, I need you to follow me. Get the samples on the way down, but just don't stop, all right? We'll go all the way down. I stop in the place that I was talking about for the strawberry colado. You get the strawberry colado, we start walking again. Now I'll take you all the way to the end. Once we get to the end, you're free. You start doing your shopping on the way down, on the way back, sorry, okay? And that's where we're gonna park right there, where the tour buses are. Remember, it's number 44, okay? And our driver is Ramon.
So is this market predominantly for shop by with Americans or?
No, local people come on the weekends here. Gets back to local people on the weekends.
Because it's proximity to the beach, that's what the attraction is?
The attraction, the people, when they get family from out of town, they bring them to the Cedar Rojo, and then the food is really good here, so they come in for the food too. Believe it or not, those clams, you cannot find them in town. Like this good, you cannot find them in town. There's a little few restaurants they can actually do it. They don't do them as good as this. I don't know why it's about here, but it's just different. Same as the oysters. The oysters, you get them really, really, because it's all from here. The divers go actually in the morning right here, very early in the morning. They go diving right here. And there's a lot of rocks and reef right here. So they get the lobster, the oysters, all that's from here. The restaurants here, I usually recommend the clam or the tacos because they're fast. Because we're not gonna spend a lot of time here, so if you go and sit down in a restaurant, it's gonna take a lot of your shopping time. Okay, guys. So just if you're not interested in shopping, you can actually go and sit down in a restaurant and enjoy the food. But the, if you actually ask for a plate that needs cooking, it'll take a long time, believe me. Even if they say it's fast, it's not gonna be fast. So those clams are already cooking. Actually, as I walk you through, you'll see them. They're cooking on the grill right there, so they're pretty much ready. And the tacos, they actually make them really fast too. So this is the road we're gonna walk all the way down. So as soon as we get there, I'm set up a time, and then we'll walk all the way down there. This place always has a line, so if you're actually, and the tacos are okay, but they're not as good as the ones
on there. Who has the best tacos?
I'll show you right now. Cosarape Taco. That place is really good tacos.
Do they sell Cuban cigars?
And it's not as crowded as this one. The best thing. Yeah, Havana Banana has a walking humidor. They are the only ones that sell real Cubans here.
Real Cubans.
Havana. So I have 12:05 here in my watch. We're about the same?
Yes.
12:05? All right. So 1:35?
Yep.
That'll be an hour and a half from now, right?
Yep.
1:35 right here, guys. And we'll get back to town at 2:30.
And the way back.
Hold on, guys. A minute. Quick stop right here. Melo's place right here, guys. Guys with the bags. They have all the designer bags right here, guys. Knockoffs, of course, but they're really high quality. On this side, this real silver, guys. Real silver has really authentic silver.
60%
beautiful off pieces, guys. And they'll do a very good. I'm gonna be walking around right here. I'm always around here. I'm always keeping an eye on you guys, okay? If I don't see you here, I'll meet you at the bus at 1:35, all right? Bathroom is up there. Yeah, that's actually the same place as the clams. You can eat those clams up there, and that's a free bathroom in there. And the other free bathroom is Havana Banana. All right, guys? So go ahead and I'll see you.
Thank you.
This has been a Rockin' M production.